बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलामुअलैकुम। दिस इज़ प्रोफेसर फरहान हमीद, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ स्टैटिस्टिक्स, गवर्नमेंट इस्लामिया कॉलेज, सिविल लाइंस, लाहौर। दिस लेक्चर इज़ फॉर एमएससी स्टैटिस्टिक्स और बीएस स्टैटिस्टिक्स, 8th सेमेस्टर। एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू फाइंड मैक्सिमम लाइकलीहुड एस्टिमेटर फॉर द ज्योमेट्रिक डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन हैविंग द पीडीएफ पी इंटू 1 माइनस पी एक्स माइनस 1 विद द पैरामीटर पी। सो लेट अस बिगिन। लेट मी शो हाउ टू फाइंड द मैक्सिमम लाइकलीहुड एस्टिमेटर ऑफ ज्योमेट्रिक डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन। दिस इज द क्वेश्चन। लेट एक्स वन एक्स टू अप टू एक्स एन बी रैंडम सैंपल ऑफ साइज एन विद प्रोबेबिलिटी मास फंक्शन, बिकॉज इट इज डिस्क्रीट प्रोबेबिलिटी डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन, सो वी विल हैव प्रोबेबिलिटी मास फंक्शन एफ ऑफ एक्स पी पी इंटू 1 माइनस पी रेज टू द पावर एक्स माइनस 1 वेयर एक्स इज इक्वल टू 1 2 3 अप टू सो ऑन। द लाइक्लीहुड फंक्शन। For likelihood function, we will introduce the pi operator, the product operator. So this is pi 1 to n p into 1 minus p x minus 1. Here the p is constant. So when we apply product to it, it becomes p raised to the power n. Then 1 minus p having x minus 1 in the power. So this x will be converted into summation. Becomes summation x, and this one is a constant, will be converted into n, because when we apply summation to constant, it becomes n times the constant. So here is 1, so it becomes n. Now to make it more convenient, we take log both side to make a log likelihood function as ln of L of p. Here p power n 1 minus p power summation x minus n are multiple of each other and also having powers. So first of all they will be converted to sum, and according to the law of shifting powers before log of logarithm, log p power n will become n ln p. And similarly, log 1 minus p raised to the power summation x minus n will become summation x minus n into log 1 minus p. So this is log likelihood function. Now we will differentiate with respect to p, partially differentiate with respect to p. Here n is constant, remain outside of the derivative. Ln p, the derivative of ln is 1 over p, so it become n over p. Again, summation x minus n is independent of p, so will be as it is in the derivative of ln 1 minus p. So derivative of ln 1 minus p is 1 over 1 minus p. Again, the derivative of 1 minus p will be minus 1. So this plus will become negative. So derivative will become n over p minus 1 over 1 minus p summation x minus n. Call it equation number 1. Now we will put this first derivative equal to 0. Putting the first derivative equal to 0, we get n over p minus 1 over 1 minus p summation x minus n is equal to 0. Shifting the second term on the right hand side, we get this. Cross multiply, we get n into 1 minus p, p into summation x minus n. Multiply by n on the left hand side and multiply p on the right hand side. Np and np will get cancelled. So here p is equal to n over summation x. Now we will check whether the function is maximized at p n inverse summation x over n or not. For this, we have to take the second derivative of the first derivative or equation number 1 we have called. So differentiate 1 with respect to p. Again, n is a constant, will remain outside. Partial derivative of 1 over p, again summation x over n is constant, remain outside. Partial derivative of 1 over 1 minus p. Derivative of 1 over p is minus 1 over p square, so it becomes minus 1 over p square. Again, derivative of 1 over 1 minus p is minus 1 over 1 minus p power 2. And again, derivative of 1 minus p is minus 1. So finally, the negative sign will be retained. So we have summation x minus n over 1 minus p whole square. Again, consider here, derivative of 1 over 1 minus p is minus 1 over 1 minus p whole square. Then we have to take the derivative of 1 minus p as well, which will be minus 1. So it will become minus n over p square minus summation x minus n over 1 minus p whole square. Now taking the LCM, we get minus n into 1 minus p whole square minus p square into summation x minus n over p square into 1 minus p whole square. Multiply, opening the square and multiply by n, we get minus n minus np square plus 2np. Again, multiply by p square minus p square summation x plus np square. This np square and this np square will be cancelled out. So we get, now using the value n is equal to p summation x in here, we get minus n plus 2 times p summation x into p minus p square summation x. It become minus n plus 2 p square summation x minus p square. Here 2 p square summation x minus p square summation x will become p square summation x minus n p square summation x. Again, using n over p for summation x, we get minus n plus p square n over p. So we have minus n plus np divided by p square into 1 minus p whole square. Taking minus n common, we have minus n bracket 1 minus p. 1 minus p will be cancelled out with the denominator. This 1 minus p will be cancelled out with 1 minus p whole square. So we have minus n p square into 1 minus p. This expression would be less than 0 because n is always a positive number and range of p is 0 to 1. So this negative indicates that this whole expression is less than 0, which means that the second derivative with respect to parameter p is less than 0. So the function is maximized. So the maximum likelihood estimator for the parameter p of geometric distribution will be p hat n over summation x, that is 1 over summation x over n, or we can write it as 1 over x bar. This is the MLE for the parameter p of the geometric distribution. Hope you have understand the mathematical procedure of finding the MLE of geometric distribution. If you like, so kindly subscribe the channel so that you can get more complex videos and solutions in a very simple and comprehensive way so that you can get going with your learning. Thank you very much for giving your time. Allah Hafiz.